it's a contemplative process of discernment. And so if you're trying to figure out where you're going or what you're doing or where God fits into your life and you're having issues separating yourself from the world, the vocation care process allows you to step back and to sit still and to experience what came up today as the sound of the genuine, to experience God's voice in such a way that nothing else stands between you and that small, still voice.
I deal with college students quite regularly. And this is a great thing. They're all looking for deep spirituality. They're looking how to make a difference in the world. And they're trying to put together how their education, how their search for meaning works in a world that's not too receptive to the input of young people. This is a real way in order to channel that and to get them thinking in ways, alternative ways of leadership, in fact, that honors where they're coming from and honors their way of viewing the world and coming out of a place of genuineness and authenticity.
I would encourage them to attend the Vocation Care Training by the Fund for Theological Education because it provides them an experiential opportunity that is user-friendly, that allows them to look within themselves and look at how they can impact their world. I think it's a great group dynamic that affords them the opportunity to learn about themselves and their calling.
But I think even if you're a local pastor in a church or you're a community organizer of some sort, you can gain ideas about how to create a movement behind whatever it is that you're trying to do.
A vocation care discernment model really presents this idea of bringing in as many voices as possible and as many perspectives as possible to find a common vision that people share that they might not know that they share. So I could imagine a preacher in a congregation using this model to look at the lectionary texts or to look at texts for one season and bring people together and say, well, what do we think about Mark? Or what do we think about Revelation? Or to really like approach a topic and to get people's perspectives so they're informing the preacher and saying, well, I really need to hear about this. Something that came up in our discussions today was this common shared fear that people don't talk about in the church, and how this process really allows people to share what their fears are as well as their hopes, both within the church and in their lives more broadly. And so giving people the opportunity to hear each other's stories, and then for the preacher who's working with his congregation to hear those stories too and to be able to lift them up, to address some of those fears and anxieties, but then also the hopes of the congregation, and that preaching moment or that board meeting would be really powerful.